Hi everyone, my name is Lindsay. I'm the Associate Director of Patient Engagement at the Every Life Foundation for Rare Diseases. I help organize the YARR program. YARR stands for Young Adult Representatives of RDLA. RDLA stands for Rare Disease Legislative Advocates. Try saying that 10 times fast. YARR is a group of highly motivated 16 to 30 year olds, all connected through rare disease. Our main purpose is to instill confidence in the next generation of rare disease advocates. We advocate to bring more affordable, safe, and effective treatments to the rare disease community. We support science, we support research, we support our peers, and we absolutely support policies connecting all three. Because rare is really not that rare when you think about it. It affects over 30 million Americans. That's 1 in 10. Many times when I talk to advocates in regards to themselves or their loved ones, I hear the same sentiment about advocacy. I may not be able to change the rare disease that I have or my loved ones have, but I absolutely can change what I do about it. So for me, YARR is all about change.
Hi, my name is Shira Strongen. I'm 19 years old and I'm the founder of Sick Chicks. I live with an undiagnosed rare disease and that's why I'm a member of YARR, because I believe that young adults are the future of rare disease advocacy.
I'm Taylor Kane. I'm 20 years old and I'm the founder of Remember the Girls. I'm a carrier of an X-linked genetic disease called adrenoleukodystrophy, dystrophy, and I'm a part of YARR because I think when young people come together, they are a really powerful force.
I'm Stephanos, I'm 22 years old, and I'm a member of YARR because I'm a patient of ichthyosis and an advocate for good science in rare disease research led by young adult aspiring scientists.
My name is Nicole. I decided to join YARR because I have a rare connective tissue disease called Marfan syndrome. Marfan syndrome affects pretty much the whole body, and I inherited this illness from my mom. My sister also has it. And since we are diagnosed from a young age, my mom has always been very involved in advocacy. So growing up, I was exposed to that, and I saw firsthand the impact that advocacy can have on a community. Even as we're working and striving for a cure or even just better treatments, advocacy can really help the community come together and just find strength in that. So as I got older, I found my own voice when it came to advocacy, and I'd love to really take that to a legislative level, and I really want to make a difference.
You're stronger than you know. You're stronger than you know.
Thank you for watching.
Hi there, friends. Hi everyone, my name is Tyler Onderdonk. I'm here in Southern California and I'm a member of YARR, Young Adult Representatives for Rare Disease Legislative Advocates. It's a mouthful, I know. I joined a couple months ago because I had friends in the organization, but because I just really wanted to get involved. It sounded like an amazing thing, and my background kind of aligns to it's something that I care about, and I wanted to get involved with the program. I really think that as a constituent, you know, it doesn't matter whether or not you have a personal connection to the community, but it's something that we should all care about, and that's why I'm a part of it. My family's been a big inspiration. My brother's a type 1 diabetic, and my mom and plenty of other people in my family have been involved in the healthcare industry for longer than I've been alive. And they've been giving back and doing all that they can to better our society. And for me, that's really impactful and something that motivates me to do what I can and try and make a difference.
Hi everyone, my name is Samantha Stallings and I'm a part of YARR because I have two rare genetic disorders. One is called Lloyd's-Dietz and two is homocystinuria. Lloyd's-Dietz has only been around for a couple years now and there's still a lot of research being done. So I'm an advocate to try to get as much research for this to be done. And so hopefully I don't have to have as many struggles and surgeries and all of that go along with Lloyd's-Dietz. And two, homocystinuria is a blood clotting disorder kind of deal. And I was actually diagnosed with it 3 years ago. Both of them actually, I was diagnosed 3 years ago, but homocystinuria, you're supposed to be caught when you're younger. I'm only allowed 45 to 50 grams of protein a day. And so with that, I take formula, which helps supplement my protein. And it is very expensive. In a lot of states, it is not covered. I'm lucky I live in a state where at least half of it is covered. But I am an advocate because I believe a lot of the low protein foods and formulas need to be covered in some way, form, or fashion. Thank you.